The highlight of the games is the pentathlon, which begins with the riding event. Horses are drawn by lots, and the riders have only 15 minutes to get acquainted with their mounts. The American team of Andre, Daniels, and Lambert is ready. Here's Andre of the Navy mounting up. Starting at 5-minute intervals, a field of 60 riders battle with the clock. They face a series of 25 jumps of all kinds, plus the problem of rugged, unfamiliar terrain. Spills are not uncommon, but no rider must quit or he's disqualified. Every kind of wooded and open terrain must be negotiated along the way, and riders are judged by two standards. First, and most important, of course, is their running time. Second, their degree of success at each obstacle. Nearing the end of the rugged 3-mile course, horse and rider are often near the limits of their stamina. Surprising the forecasters, the U.S. team takes first with a healthy total of 3,020 points. Finland is second and Russia third. The second pentathlon event is fencing. Here's Andre of the Navy again, ready to go into action. The fencers probe warily with their electrified foils, knowing that according to pentathlon rules, a single hit decides the winner. Final judging puts Hungary first, but the U.S. still leads as a team. Next comes the shooting, and again the pentathlon rules make it a tough event. The targets appear for only 3 seconds, disappear for 10. This happens exactly 20 times, and each man must get off 20 shots, so there's no margin for error. The judges find Mexico first in the shooting, America still leading on overall point score. In the swimming event, each competitor must swim 300 meters freestyle against the clock. This is one of our strong events, but even so, the Russian team picks up several points, narrowing down the lead we've built up. The next event will tell the story. In the final event, the cross-country run, Lieutenant Andre, number 36, leaves the starting mark. Spaced 1 minute apart, the runners once again pit themselves against the clock. The distance is roughly 2.5 miles, and each man faces a grave handicap in judging his pace over the course, since the terrain is completely unfamiliar to each of them. Pentathlon rules state that each runner must see the course for the first time as he runs it, following the white tape which marks the trail. In addition, the terrain is chosen for those features which will make the strongest demands on both the stamina and judgment of each runner. In a surprise finish, the well-trained Russian team shows unexpected strength, recording times which put them in first place. America finishes out of the money in this event, but scores an upset by taking second in the overall pentathlon scoring. Third place goes to Finland.
On closing day, 100,000 spectators jam the stadium to see representatives of all nations march onto the field. Symbolizing the unifying influence of sportsmanship, the nations are not grouped separately, but march as one unit. The last race is run, the last medal presented, and the 16th Olympiad of the modern era is officially coming to a close. Now the world of sport looks ahead to 1960 and Rome, where once again the athletes of all nations will speak the words which express the spirit of the Olympiad. We swear that we will take part in these Olympic Games in the true spirit of sportsmanship, and that we will respect and abide by the rules which govern them. for the glory of sport and the honor of our country.